Here is an example usage of the tree data structure, which is the so-called heap. So what is the heap? Well, it's a binary tree data structure, but additionally we have the heap property that must be satisfied. What is the heap property? Well, there are two heap properties. It depends on the type of heap you have. If you have a max heap, you have this expression, otherwise it's a min heap. Let's find out what a max heap means. A max heap means for any node that you have, like the root is a node, if you have a parent of this node, then the key of the parent must be bigger and larger number than the current node. So let's see if this is satisfied here. This is a node. For any node Z, so this is node Z, if P is a parent, this is a parent, then the key of the parent must be bigger than the key of the child. It is. So this is 17 and this is 19. Right? So now this node is another node C, so the parent of this node must be bigger. It's 100, so it's bigger. So that is how it works. So on the root node, we have always now the biggest number, basically. On a min heap, it's just the opposite. You have the smallest number on the root. And with the help of a heap, you can implement an abstract data structure called priority queue, which means you can basically get the value that is their biggest by extracting the root very easily. Good, let's have a look about the operations that you want to do with the max heap. Well, you want to get the maximum element. We want to find it or peek at it. Then we want to extract this number, means to remove it. And after we return a number, or we insert, by the way, a number, we have to make sure that the heap satisfies our heap property, right? So we must reconstruct this heap property again. So when we insert or replace a node, it's true as well. So the implementation of a heap is not trivial. You will learn, I think, more about this in algorithms. But to be said, the complexity of this algorithm is very nice to find. So to peak at the maximum, it's O of 1, because the maximum is always on the root. So that's just cheap to find more about it. And to extract and to insert something, it's logarithmical, which is very nice. So that means basically every time you insert something, you have to do some operations up to the depth of the heap. Okay, that's why it's logarithmic, because a depth of a tree in terms of the number of nodes that a tree can hold is logarithmic. This stems from the fact where we learned about the number of elements that are in a tree, which is a power of 2, then the height, right? So with a height of 9, basically you can have about 1023 elements in such a tree. Okay. Now we can use the heap for something really cool, for sorting in particular. So how, think about it, how could you use this heap for sorting? And then think about the complexity it may have to create this kind of sorting algorithm using our heap data structure. So remember, extracting and inserting something into tree has log n performance cost. And well, how could you use this data structure? Look at this example. How could you use this to sort a set of data? Think about it, and I will reveal the answer in a minute. Here is now the conclusion of this little task. This algorithm is called heap sort. The idea is you insert all the elements into the heap and then iteratively remove the minimum or the maximum, depending on the kind of heap that you have. And that will lead to a complexity of n log n. Let's have a look how this algorithm works in detail. So we get this list of elements or this array. We create our heap, and then for each element of our list that we want to sort, we insert it in the heap. Inserting something in the heap has a complexity of log n. So since we do this n times, we have here a complexity to insert it that is n log n. After that, we create a new array, which we call sorted. And in this array, to use this array, we use the heap extract minimum function in this example. And as long as we can get a minimum, we basically put it into this array. And you can easily imagine in this little case, so we extract 100 because it's a max heap and we know that's basically the biggest number. Then this heap gets reorganized. After that, we extract this 36. Then the heap would be reorganized. The 25 would be now on the root. We would extract 25, then we'd extract 19, 17, and so on until this is basically sorted.